Hey, everybody. Welcome back. It's Mystery Titans Theater. My name is Travis Woloshyn, and I'm joined, as always, by Johnny Hedgebeth. Johnny, how are you?
I'm doing good.
This one is a special episode because for the first time, all the creative endeavors I've done my whole life, it's the first time I've been able to finagle or wrangle a family member. I got my brother here, Paul. Paul Woloshyn, how are you?
Splendid, thank you.
And another guy who may as well be a member of the family. We've known him forever. Sasky Naslund. Sasky, what's happening?
Not much. Looking forward to tonight.
Yeah. So we've been talking about these guys are, Johnny, these guys are casual fans, but love, I would say, this is the era that they're the most familiar with. Mm-hmm. It's an interesting era. 89 here. This is kind of the lead in to the pay-per-view, right?
Yeah, I guess this is some like specialty on USA to hype the pay-per-view. Mm-hmm. This is 89 when I was not watching wrestling.
Yeah.
Well, for Pete's sakes, it's the Showdown?
Yes. It's a setup. So we're gonna
Watch the pay-per-view.
Yeah, no, man, that's not what we do here. That's got guaranteed good matches. We don't know if there's gonna be anything good on this. That's how we do this shit. That's how we try to get through this. We've already got to see some Winnipeg testicles, so that's okay.
It only costs $15 on a corner of Winnipeg. That's how
I Manitoba mullet on that.
Yeah, for sure.
Is he Matt Tobin?
Yep. That's what Winnipeg can hold him and Jericho. And a couple of greats here. I listened to, or I watched today when I was doing laundry, SummerSlam 89. And that's when Shivani was there, Johnny. How long was Shivani in WWF?
It wasn't long, but again, I didn't see any of it. I just know that to this day, he regrets quitting.
Yeah. He was great. It was him and Jesse, right?
I think so. Like you said, I wasn't watching it.
Yeah.
I was 19 years old, Travis. It was time to put aside wrestling for Grateful Dead shows and, you know, pussy.
Yep, we know.
I have no idea who Shivani is.
Tony Shivani was an announcer. He ended up working for WCW, became known for like the WCW guy.
And he was originally, he was the Crockett NWA, which became WCW. He was the big time announcer down there. He came up for a cup of coffee up north and decided he didn't like the weather or what have you, and went back and has done quite well for himself, but he regrets.
He does AEW now, but he also does does he do Georgia football games or something?
Oh, yeah,
like
he does all minor league baseball, all kinds of shit. Yeah.
He's awesome. He's one of the best. What's that?
Is he with a network? I feel like it was CBS.
I don't know. Maybe the local, whatever the local affiliate, maybe.
He's on TNT right now with that's just wrestling.
That's right. But even if there's like a Georgia Bulldogs football game, he has to do that over I remember he's chosen that over AEW pay-per-views.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah.
Twin Towers. And a great entrance music. Jive Soul, bro. Man, and look, he had the stars and bars, hey? I didn't notice that when I mean...
It was Cobb County, Georgia. It was authentic.
Yeah, I guess, right?
Yeah, I don't think that was a choice of Ray Trailers that he's going to wear the stars and bars. He was trying to look like an authentic cop from Cobb County, Georgia.
Yeah, he's a scary dude.
Did he have a name? Is he like an officer or something? Rather than Big Boss Man?
He was just the Big Boss Man.
He wasn't Officer Jefferson or something?
No. He would have been Officer Rogers because his original name was Big Bubba Rogers.
Right. Awesome.
Tito, man.
Yeah. And Dusty. And good God, Jesse will call him Chico 1,000 times. 1,000.
That outfit, he looks like the third killer bee there. The one who didn't quite make the cut.
Yeah. The story is that. So he was well known for those territories that Johnny was talking about earlier, Dusty, obviously. And when he came over here, polka dots were put on him as a joke, but he really, Dusty made it work.
Yeah, he was just like, you know, he's like, we're going to put polka dots on. He wasn't even just over the territories. He was the booker for Crockett. Right. I mean, he's like one of the biggest stars of all time.
Yeah,
and
he
to
is.
Wrap up his career, Vince is like, gonna put you in polka dots, pal. Mm-hmm. And Dusty basically was like, man, you can put me in anything. I wore Thalia stuff in the past. I'll get it over. And he did. People loved it. People loved the polka dots.
Yeah.
Hey, what do you guys think that there's going to be a chair brought out from underneath the ring this whole TV show?
No.
Out of all of these? Not a single?
You're not going to see any foreign objects being brought into the ring, you think?
Yeah, the Billy Club is going to come out. That's for sure.
Maybe the Billy Club, yep.
But for the rest of the whole show?
One chair. Will we see a chair shot?
Will a chair get brought out from under the ring?
Well, I mean, there's this guy Zeus who's involved at this point, Johnny. That's the era we're in, right? The no holds barred pay-per-view. The guy who's an actor, but he's not a wrestler. But they're just booking him like a monster, right? So they'll try to hit him with stuff. So I can see him taking a chair shot to the to the back selling it.
Tiny Lister, who's not a bad actor.
He's great. He's the president in Fifth Element. He's in Jackie Brown. He's got a great part in Jackie Brown.
He's got a small but very great part in The Dark The Dark Knight.
Right.
I just remember the lazy eyes, so I don't know. He might have trouble locating. He might have trouble locating that chair under the
that's
mat.
A good point. That's a good point.
He'll be seeing double.
You got some of the some 1980s racial sensitivity here with Jesse constantly calling Tito Chico, and that Akeem the African Dream out here,
right? And also, you know, just the little touch is the sombrero on the tights.
He's proud.
Yeah,
it's his choice.
I remember, God, those are his same Strike Force tights from when he was in the tag team, and that we used to just make fun of how he never got new tights. He just since then. Yeah. I mean, we'll probably see Rick Martel at some point, his tag team, the other guy in Strike Force, and he's got a whole new gimmick.
Well, why would he?
I don't know. Yeah, I know.
Who are we talking about?
Tito. Like, you see those the white tights and the lightning bolts? That's from his tag team, Strike Force.
Who's the guy in the Canucks jersey there?
Akeem, a.k.a. Whoa, selling like awesome. That was great.
I knew this match was good because both these guys are fucking great.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Akeem the African Dream, who for many years in the territories and briefly here, he was the one man gang, and he was scary looking. Like he looked he was really frightening looking at a mohawk. He was a biker who was so mean, no one would be in a gang with him. So he was literally the one-man gang. Yeah. And Vince decided, he's like, all right, to make fun of Dusty.
Again, to make fun of Dusty, the same fucking thing.
To make fun of Dusty, who wasn't working there yet. He's like, we're going to turn you into, you're going to find your African roots. They had a ceremony in a parking lot with Slick and they were burning fire in a barrel.
Yeah, really.
And he's coming. He's just like a big fat white guy out there, dance, shucking, and jiving, and make fun of Dusty Rhodes. Yeah.
No, I remember the one man gang. Yeah, that was pretty funny. There's some pretty classic characters back in these days.
Yeah, even here, this is kind of, we're coming down from Hulkamania at this point, but there's still a ton of the colorful characters. They hadn't gone into the everybody being a blue collar job or everybody having a job at some point.
That didn't happen until the early 90s.
Yeah. So it's just around the corner.
You just had a cop and a barber.
Yeah, at this point, that's all you need. Just a small town, just a fresh milk here.
And even the boss man one worked. He's the whole idea, like, he's an ex-prison guard who.
Right.
You know, who was fired for police brutality or some shit. Yeah.
So,
you know,
so now like, I gotta do this.
Kind of works.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if that would work in today's WWE.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
he was a pretty good character back in the day.
Yeah,
Voss fans bleeding hard.
Yeah, he got a little bit of it was.
Tito him in the nose.
Did Bossman ever hold a belt?
Not in
WWE.
Well, okay, he came back in the 90s during the 90s boom.
In the black outfit.
Yeah, and he had the hardcore belt a bunch. So did 85
everybody
other guys,
and their dog.
So,
yeah.
Because you would say he's considered a top 12 wrestler during this time, during the 80s, top 10
in this roster. He had just come off. This is just after a main event run with Hogan, I think. So yeah,
like he's in video games.
Yep. Yeah.
10 years.
Yeah, he had a wrestling buddy.
Paul, how old were you back in this day? Was this like you were 6 years old?
5 or 6.
Yeah, Paul was 6 at this point. I had just turned 12.
Yeah, you and I would have been the same. You were practicing suplexes on Paul back then, Trav?
yeah, still hadn't figured out the sharpshooter yet.
Yeah.
Because Brett hadn't become big, but there's not a single...
Final Clutch was in...
Yeah, more in vogue at this point. But there's not a move I put on Paul more than... Oh, this is nice.
Can your state of mind affect your music?
What the fuck?
Oh, here we go.
Now Ron.
That's awesome. Wow.
That's sad, dude. God damn that ad.
That's crazy.
I thought that said diuretics at first.
Diuretics. The
Scientology ad.
Look at this wrestling game,
This is why I've really got you guys on here, because I wanted to introduce you to somebody named Zanu. Forgot. I'm just slowly converting you. I tricked you into getting converted into Scientology. The cleansing begins.
Sucked.
This controller.
That Dianetics commercial used to play constantly, and I, as a kid, I never even knew what it was about. I was just like, no one ever talked about it. It was just this ad that ran all the time. I just figured it was a, science fiction book,
which it basically is, right? This is awesome.
Have you heard of that book?
Okay, here we go.
Yeah, L. Ron Hubbard. It's the guy, Battlefielder, the guy who created Scientology, or like one of the.
Hey, that previous commercial, wasn't that Famke Janssen?
Maybe.
I think it was.
Wow,
are you over
30? Pretty young.
I am.
That's how old we are.
1909. Okay, I got it.
Oh,
I'm using my rotary dialer right now.
Oh, look at this. You two can make out with a senior.
Gross.
Hey, I like the older ladies.
Purple hair ties dripping down your sweater.
That's how you know
it's
hot. I want
to show my face.
This guy doesn't either.
Yeah, everybody's got their shit. There's a lot of commercials. So I think this was 5... I think it aired, there were 20 minutes over the course of 5 weekdays to boost this thing.
Steve Landisberg and Gil Gerard, Luis Fletcher, I'm watching this. That's Buck Rogers, baby.
Oh, what the hell's going on there?
Uh-huh. That's the weirdest.
Steve Landisberg.
The weirdest statue I've ever seen. It's been a while since you've seen my balls, ain't it?
He just got a balloon on his finger.
It had been filled with coke about an hour earlier.
Yeah, he pulled it out of his asshole.
That's how he got it into Titan Towers.
Oh, he's just always on. Roddy's always on when that camera starts rolling.
Dirty move out of this.
Actually, Tito's awesome, though.
Like
Tito's
checking to see if his baby pooped.
Smell that? You smell that? Y'all smell that? Was that you, Tito? 619. No, he does that a lot. And look at that classic smiley face with the bullet in the brain. 89. That's what all the weirdos wore in 89.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Hypercolor shirts too.
But those weren't quite on trend yet, I don't think.
Hey, what was that phone number again, guys?
1-909-88.
Age 88. Tito's the best. Tito is one of like the best, just pure baby faces ever, man.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he had a long career, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's a teacher now.
Is he really?
Yeah, on old podcast I used to do, I wasn't able to be part of it because they had to time it while I was working, but we got Tito Santana on as a guest.
Oh, that's awesome.
And he was great.
I saw him live as a kid. He was pretty popular back in the day.
That was awesome.
Oh, yeah, Tito was always super popular.
Yeah.
Nazzy, did you go to some live shows?
Did I? Yeah. Oh, yeah. We went. They used to come around, and, you know, I remember seeing a bunch of different characters and stuff.
Just the Regina show?
It was the Regina show. But, you know, Hogan came by. It would have been around this time, right? Like, Hogan. Of course, you know, my all-time favorite, Randy Macho Man. That's why I was there.
Yeah, we'll see him at some point.
So, yeah, there was a lot of different characters that came through on that circuit. But, like, you know, Bret the Hitman was always doing that as well.
I guess they never had, like, the weekly primetime show until 90s, right?
Yeah,
no, that's right. Not a primetime. No. And we saw
Saturday night.
Yeah, we get Maple Leaf Wrestling, which was, like, essentially Superstar Challenge with Stampede. No, Nazzy, I knew this was going to come up, that you're from Regina, and Johnny and I do another podcast about a TV show, and one of the actresses, like, and he was doing research on her. And
yeah. It's
called Gideon Guys, yeah. DC's Legends of Tomorrow. It says here she's from Regina, Saskatchewan. I'm like, oh, man. Oh, man, come on.
This is like the gift that keeps on giving with you. This is the second time.
That's perfect. I knew that was going to come up. But I had to explain, the city that rhymes with fun. And then I explained that Paul taught me that some people call it runt.
Or the vag. That's always a good one. That's usually what they call it. But...
the vag.
And this rest name, sorry.
Heppner, Earl Heppner.
Yeah. Oh, no, is this Earl or Dave?
Dave.
This might be Dave Heppner. Because Earl Heppner was in Crockett, and they brought him up here to be the evil twin referee for that Hogan deal, which I guess they happened before this. And he stuck around too. So who could tell them they're twins?
You know, I gotta say though, you watch the Big Boss Man, he could move pretty good for his size.
Yeah.
That was just athletic. The dude was a tall, big belly, but he was an amazing athlete. He could do all kinds of shit.
It doesn't look like he expels a lot of energy when he's running or moving.
Yeah.
Like, he knows where to reserve his energy.
Right.
But he can also take these amazing bumps, you know.
Like we saw him just
climb over the top rope.
Flip out of the ropes, yeah. And stuff like that.
Like that.
Oh. Throw the X up. That was a bad one.
It's like his shin slid down the rope into the turnbuckle thing in behind the turnbuckle.
Ah! Ah!
Do you think Batu's going to win this one or what?
I think we're going to get a schmoz.
I see
people already up on the.
Yeah.
I think Boss Man will win. Probably.
Did
he have a finishing? What was his?
Here we go. He's getting hit him with a stick.
The belly club,
that's it.
His finisher was like
otherwise here comes Dusty. Oh, right.
Nice. He has a nice stick for you too, brother. Oh, there we go.
Oh.
It's a dusty finish. I'm involved, baby.
No, a dusty finish is disappointing.
Arriba, you won it.
That was good. I like that finish.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
Not bad. You know, it's funny when you watch these old videos like this and you see the fans all into it. Like, it was just a different era in wrestling.
Big time. That's the one thing I noticed from watching, around this era, because that's what I was watching SummerSlam today when I was doing laundry, I said. And didn't matter what babyface, if they won a match, there was a pop for it. The crowd would go crazy for it. And that just does not happen now at all.
Well, it's right now, it's less and less kids.
Right.
Yeah.
And it's more just dudes, you know, watching it trying to watch it with a critical eye.
Yeah.
Oh, really? Yeah.
It's, yeah.
in their parents' basement like we are tonight.
Exactly.
Growing our neck beards.
Yeah, that's right.
I love how good.
Gorilla had glasses that matched each of his jackets.
the hue.
Yeah,
that's money, man. That's nice.
You know, I would say though, like, it's funny you watch Bobby the Brain. I mean, he had to have been the biggest heel manager back in those days. Like, everyone hated him.
Yep, he was the best.
But he was good at it. He did not. I saw it myself.
I was there alive. He was also the most, probably the most all-around talented person ever in pro wrestling.
Yeah, it's possible, yeah.
He was an amazing wrestler in his youth. He is one of the greatest manager of all time. And as an announcer, he's one of the greatest of all time, too. He's just... He's got the quick wit of a comic. He's, you know, there's he could have been a stand-up.
Yeah.
That's how funny this guy was.
This time in 89, he maybe does two more. Like, I remember rarely watching him.
Who, Heenan?
Not so much in 89.
Who, Piper?
No, the Hart. Or Bobby Bryan.
He didn't wrestle at this point.
I remember watching him wrestle like two times.
Oh, once in a blue moon.
I remember he got into shit with Warrior at this point. He ended up having to get dressed up in a weasel suit. Yeah, that kind of thing.
Here we go. See, I mean, I saw the Grateful Dead there.
Yeah.
Stay here. No, did not.
These are all around my birthday around this time.
Oh, it's like.
We go to Milwaukee.
Saw the Dead there, definitely. And wrestling there.
I'm turning 12.
Sorry, Johnny, where are you? Where are you from?
Oh, there's another one. I'm from Jersey originally. I live in Colorado now, though.
I just assumed you were in BC there in Vancouver, but yeah.
No, maybe someday.
We talk about
Hershey, Pennsylvania.
Start allowing Americans into the country again.
Yeah.
Hey.
Dude, we can't even go from province to province at this point, so I'm not.
Oh no,
not
no,
meant
it's
to be a slight.
Oh no, it's a ways to go, but when it's all over, I want to take a long weekend vacation in Vancouver. It's not that far from there.
Yeah.
No.
Introducing Game Boy.
Oh my God.
This is rad.
Is he Game Boy? Is this kid Game Boy?
Or is that the game?
Okay.
The two of them.
That robot is dancing and wants to have sex with Game Boy. This is not fun.
But he beat him to it.
Game Boy.
I didn't know we'd get this many commercials, but
I do not mind. Oh, that looks like my buddy Theo's older brother.
Oh,
is this some white guy? Is this some late 80s white guy blues?
Blues?
Three must be. Hey, guys, we scored a gig. Daddy,
hey, Harry Anderson is pissed.
Yeah, I like chocolate bars.
Speaking of shitty white guys doing the blues, Eric Clapton's a piece of shit.
Yeah, man. Oh, boy. That sucks. And that's funny. I learned that Van Morrison has done like four anti-lockdown songs.
He's already.
I mean, we knew he was, but he's already done four. Oh, come on!
But then when people are like, "Oh, this is hilarious," people are like, of course, this old thing came up of some amazingly racist screed Clapton did from a stage in the 70s.
Oh, really?
About keeping England white and using all kinds of slurs, and. The excuses were like, oh, come on, it was the 70s. He was on a lot of drugs. I was like, listen, Jerry Garcia did all the drugs. In the 70s. Was a racist piece of shit. Fuck him.
Yeah, that sucked.
He stole his best friend's wife. He completely lost faith. He completely lost faith in his gifts, apparently, the first time he saw Hendrix. That was like sent him on a death spiral.
This is Clapton you're talking about?
Yeah, Clapton's a piece of shit.
Yeah. Didn't he throw his kid out a fucking window?
No, I don't think he threw his kid out the window. No, worse, he wrote a song about it.
I know.
No, he wrote the song.
Allegedly. Yeah, and that a hit song. Exactly. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Let me see the long
He wrote
con.
The song. Long no, con. Maybe you're right. Maybe you're right. He wrote the song and realized that if this is a piece of shit's going to be a hit, I'm going to have to throw this fucking baby out the window.
It's an old joke. What's the difference between a bag of cocaine and a baby? Eric Clapton would never drop a bag of cocaine out of window.
space to get that magazine.
Speaking of cocaine. I love those magazines.
I love that Mean Gene was a fan of the cocaine around this time, and I'd love to see this guy on coke.
It just whacked out. Shirt off.
Uh-oh.
Oh, nice. And the Brainbusters were there at this time. But babyface demolition doesn't make much sense. But it works with, like, Tully and Arn are, like, the best, you guys.
Yeah.
This is one of the best finishing moves.
Yeah.
It actually looked like it hurt.
I know.
Yeah, there's probably a lot of vicious kid fights jumping off the couch in that with the
friends. Oh, one of those. Yeah.
And the little brothers down there while one buddy's off the couch.
This might have been their last match, the Brainbusters. Do you think, Johnny? No, were they done here at that time?
No, Tully's on this show.
Oh yeah, right.
I don't know if Arn, because Tully got fired or whatever, and then Arn quit right at the same time.
Bullshit. So this is just a sneak peek in this Survivor Series.
Yeah, just like the way that they're just trying to sell.
I was like, how are they catching so much if it's a weekly show? Like,
No, this is a special to get people to buy it.
Here comes number two.
This came right out of Howard Finkel's ass. It's filled with Peruvian marching. This is what my balls look like. Let me lift up my fucking kilt.
No, we know. We know what they look like. We've seen it every wide shot. You had to go now and entirely mess up the Brainbusters career. Hell, you're the one that messed up. I don't think he was wrestling at this time. Piper. The blame is
going to lay on your shoulders.
No, he was. Yeah, they bring him in for announcing.
It was so rare for me to see a Piper fight.
Yeah.
At the age of six, like it was.
And even when he was acting.
Can't do that these days.
My God, do that. If you stumble over one word,
he's like, I'm gonna lick his balls. That's what.
Oh, he's wrapping it up. When he was a promise, that's the pipe of promise.
When he was 14 years old, living on the streets of Canada, having to fend for himself, doing whatever he had to do, that's the little signal he did.
Man, we're getting a lot of ads on this. Ah, no. Uh-oh.
The Adventure
Back
continues.
To Future 2.
Which I love, by the way.
Yeah, Nora just watched, binged two in a row when we were cleaning up, and Christine gave me shit for not giving her something else to do. But she was way into it. They're both really good, obviously. And the third one's great, too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. The third one was pretty decent for him.
Oh, here we go. Here's how we break the glass ceiling. In America.
Twin Towers. Wow. Remember those guys?
She's addicted to this shit, apparently.
Hmm.
You're the fire of the year. I got a boat and I'm gonna meet. There he is.
I'll be scum.
Oh, actually, I was just bringing you your briefcase. I did not expect to be hijacked.
Yeah.
Hello.
That's exactly, yeah. She's going to kill him. She's going to kill him out on the...
Yeah, she's pulling a Dexter. Yeah. Going to throw him in the water.
My life is in there! No. Then call your insulation contractor
and insulate safely with certain... What is this, spray?
We'll just fill the cocaine in your house.
It's just everything. Every commercial.
It's 89.
89, yeah.
It's 89. Look at all the cocaine, Howard!
We're gonna be rich.
The cocaine.
It's so weird.
See, look, more. I tell you,
this is like something that a weirdo would hand you on a piece of paper when you're walking down the street. What? I have no idea what this means.
The best thing is this is on a wrestling show. Yes. And it's like, why is your mind clouded? I got a lot of reasons.
It's a part of a gimmick. It's an upcoming gimmick.
I'm using 10% of my mind right now. So yeah.
It's gonna be a new wrestler.
Oh yeah, like I was saying, guys.
The diet. He's,
so stage one is you cut ties from your family. I hope we're okay with that. Man, Christine watches so many of those Scientology things where it freaks me out.
The Leah Remini.
Yeah, yeah, all that kind of shit. Yeah.
I kind of love Leah Remini because I remember when she was super into it and she was annoying about it publicly, and for her to turn around and be like public enemy number one, I'm like, good on her.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. That's huge.
Like, they want her dead. They want her dead.
I know.
What's that?
What's that actress's name?
Leah Remini. Was on King of Queens.
Yeah.
Like, Patton Oswalt used to tell stories that she was annoying on the set to want to talk to everyone about Scientology. The genius. Yeah, this was in 89. Some of this shit was so hokey, I totally checked out.
Yeah. Like, you
know, I don't want to get caught watching this.
Randy probably wasn't too proud of this guy.
No. He loved him, dude. Randy Savage's whole thing was his utter devotion to his family. That's why Poffo was here. That's why Poffo was in WCW making $150,000 a year and never wrestled one match.
Yeah, just because he was looking out for him.
Oh, yeah.
I always thought, though, this gimmick was like one of the hokiest gimmicks out of them all, though.
Yeah.
Like, he's...
But he got a win over Hogan.
Got over.
Count out. It did. Yeah. And it was good. It was good when he was Perfect's manager. I like that.
Yeah. That's looking back on it now with just the fun eye of what it was. He's great as the genius.
Yeah.
I could suck my own cock.
Yeah, that's what he's well known for backstage, you guys, just so you know.
Yep.
That's a legend among the boys.
Yep. To entertain his coworkers, he would suck
his it out, everybody. Cock. Ha-ha, not only am I smart.
I gotta say, though, Mr. Perfect, man, next to Macho Man for me, I love Mr. Perfect.
Yeah, me too. Great. He was the first heel I remember cheering for.
Yeah. Well, and he was his gimmick was so good, even when he was, like, on the basketball court.
Yeah, the vignettes.
You know, throwing no-look shots, and, you know, it was pretty good.
He threw a football to himself.
Yeah.
He was like, Nazzy, you should look up the documentary on him and see how tight he was with Wade Boggs, like best of friends, like lifelong friends. Wade Boggs tells a story about how he saved his life. Dude, it's awesome.
Really?
Yeah.
They were hunting together. Wade Boggs, I don't know, what did he shoot himself in the leg or some shit?
Yeah, and got like stuck on something and he had to carry him all the way home. Yeah.
And Kurt Hennig here, Mr. Perfect, lifted up Wade Boggs and carried him to safety, saving his life. Now look, you see, that was I always knew him as Kurt Hennig, and so they called him Mr. Perfect. I thought that was silly and cartoony too, but it is I love the gimmick now.
Yeah.
Now these guys, boy, Kurt Hennig's great, but this match.
Get the fuck out of my face, that guy in the front row. I'm not interested. I'm here with my fucking kid.
They look like some of their relatives from Saskatchewan. Coming over for Christmas dinner. Oh, you know, actually, probably not. They got too many teeth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You recognize that ref? Danny Davis.
He looks like our neighbor.
Danny Davis. Yeah, I remember him.
So this is post heel turn. Like, he's just back to being a ref.
Yeah, he got his job back. Like, okay, no more of that cheating. All right.
I promise.
Well, I hope Mr. Perfect annihilates him.
Yeah, he should. We'll get to see a nice perfect flexor. We'll see what he can do with this. He's getting... Why are you booing me? I thought... Oh, he's over there. Oh, it's because he stood up.
It's still always amazing to me because the Bushwhackers were the sheep herders in the territories for decades, and they were known as these like barbed wire... brawling bad guys who were always covered in blood and had bloodbath matches like all over the world. And Vince brought him up and was like, I'm gonna turn you into baby
full of teddy bears, basically.
Just a bunch of teddy bears. And they were like, if you could do that, you know, I'll
tear your balls off.
And and it worked.
Yeah.
And it worked.
Yeah.
They were a big tag team.
Yeah. It's basically
I loved them as a kid.
Yeah, that's exactly what their demo, right?
Yeah,
and it was like a retirement plan for them, you know. They didn't have
it. They made more money from this and toys and merchandise, not having to bump or cut themselves with razor blades.
Right.
You know.
I saw Vladimir in the front row there, Johnny.
Oh, Vlad was there? Yeah, I've met Vlad. Vlad's a nice guy.
Famous wrestling fan, especially from the 80s.
make your writing sharp.
What is that?
It's the Mr. Perfect writing tool, apparently.
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like, yeah, it's for the six-year-olds. They don't get too tied into the storyline.
Yeah.
Just love these Bushwhackers.
It's like you, Paul. Yeah.
They were these, he turned, but the fact that he turned these two guys, like Vince McMahon looked around the chair, he's like, who can I sell to the kiddies and have them lick children? I got it. These two guys covered in barbed wire. Oh, he likes this. Yeah. Hey, look, I have family from Kentucky, so I can.
Guy's biting my ass. What the fuck is this?
Oh, he's biting his ass cheeks.
So I have to. All right, so Travis, you've heard this. I have to tell the story. I can't remember which one of the Bushwhackers did this, and this is just a story. But apparently he was known for pulling this incredibly funny practical joke with his coworkers in the shower. They'd have their eyes all soaped up with shampoo. He'd get down on his knees, put their dick in his mouth. They'd look down like, and he'd go, blew your gimmick, mate. And they'd all <he'd> laugh.
Just Butch being Butch.
I think it was Luke.
Whatever.
I don't want to say that because Luke is gay, so that's the first one. Like, so it could have been, but who knows?
Snap me. Yeah, some of the Hennig, Mr. Perfect, and Brett matches are awesome, and Brett considers them among the best he had.
Yeah,
he says that one of the best matches he ever had was in Saskatoon, I think, with him. I think that's what he talks about in his book. Does that sound right, Johnny?
I don't remember.
Or it might have been like Alaska. I remember he does really talk about his matches with Hennig.
Yeah, they were pretty, well, and they're very similar in the way that they could sell it. It looked pretty real, right?
Mm-hmm. And good, like, crisp execution. Like that. I hope we get to see a perfect flex here.
It was excellent execution.
Yep.
But I was in and out of wrestling from 88 through like 94, but every now and then I'd pop in and out. And I didn't see, the first time I saw the Bret Hart, Mr. Perfect SummerSlam match where Bret wins the Intercontinental belt for the first time, I was at a go-go club in Jersey. It's like, it's a strip club, but since they served alcohol, there was no nudity, but you know, girls were flashy and stuff and everything. And it was a Saturday afternoon, the place was packed. For whatever reason, they had a videotape of SummerSlam 92 on. And I'm looking at girls shaking their tatas at me and everything. And suddenly this match comes on and I'm just transfixed. I'm like, not watching anything, but I'm like, God damn, that was good. That was amazing.
That was a nice little, what do you call that? I don't even know what you call that.
The Nutcracker, I don't know.
Yeah.
You know, the more I look at it, you watch Kurt Hennig and Mr. Perfect looks like Bret the Hitman, just a blonde.
Yeah, sure.
You know, if they would have been the Heart Foundation, they would have looked like, it would have been good.
Yeah. One in pink, one in black.
Same hair.
And then earlier in their careers, they were both also just white, pasty, and doughy.
Yeah, that's right.
Then at this point, they hit the gym and the
vitamins.
Yeah. Kurt Hennig has an all-time great match with Nick Bockwinkel, an hour long. Is it a draw? Does it end in a draw, Johnny?
I can't remember.
I can't remember either. That match is insane.
And I'm not a big fan of hour-long matches.
Me neither.
At all, but that match is great.
Yeah.
This guy's... That guy almost stole his hat.
There we go.
Mortarboard. God damn it. There it is.
It's only pointing one toe. A little lazy there, Kurt.
Oh, here we go.
Great, great theme music as well, entrance music. Yeah.
Yeah. Was there ever any doubt?
Yeah. Also, this gives you, keeps their heat up for the match that they're involved in Survivor Series, right?
And well, it's less about keeping heat or anything like that. It's like, we want to get these people happy. Let's
sure. Especially
make the kids cheer.
Thinking about 6-year-old Paul here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think Paul's walking around the house doing the bushwhacker walk right now.
Did you walk like that right into Travis's room? I don't want you to bully me anymore.
Yeah. And then I went sheep herders on him.
Yeah.
It got
no, you blew your gimmick, mate. You went.
So, I've heard about you, Canadian. How can you get away with that? That's fucking insane.
Were you guys skipping these ads or what?
Nope.
I keep getting these pop-ups.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Want to know what time we're at right now?
Yeah, where are you at on it?
41:18.
41:20.
We got Roddy flicking his third bean bag.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, yeah.
I just can't get it off.
I had trouble finding this one. I got her though.
It's up there pretty far.
I think he's got two balloons. You just can't see where the second one is. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He makes Howard Finkel mule them into the studio.
Finkel, why is Finkel his mule? Just, oh yeah, because he's notoriously abused by those guys. That's true. That's probably the guy. It'd be him or Matilda.
The dog.
What
they did to that dog.
Or Damien. I love Sean Mooney.
I hated Sean Mooney when I
really
around this time I turned around. I just thought he seemed too. It all just seemed too fake.
Yeah, but he's such a dweeb. He's the perfect dweeb.
No, he's a cool dude. Now I've seen him in real life. And here's the thing: he briefed when the UPN network first launched. It was the WB and the UPN. They were the two new networks. They launched at the same time, and UPN's whole thing was. Real quick, was Star Trek Voyager, and that dude, and Rick Rude was the news anchor. Sean Mooney, he got a brief shot of being a national news anchor on that network.
Hilarious.
I hate Rick Rude.
Really?
I love Rick Rude. He's one of my favorite.
When he would kiss somebody from the crowd, yeah. I'd get so mad. Like, what if that was your mom that he pulled up?
Yeah.
Like. I was so empathetic.
Just so disrespectful.
And then like jiving his hips over her face.
Yeah. What are you doing to my mother?
Whose girlfriend was it that he always put on his tights all the time?
I remember he put Jake's wife, Cheryl Roberts.
Yeah, it was Jake the Snake.
It was Jake Roberts' wife.
Yeah, that's hilarious.
I love Rick. My ex-wife, there was somebody, she would watch wrestling with me, and she'd tell me flat out who she thought. She told me that when she was a teenager, she'd watch it every now and then, and that Rick Rude was her favorite. She's like, oh, yeah. Super hot for Rick Rude. And Rick That's Rude, hilarious. And then I took her to a few Ring of Honor shows, and she saw CM Punk, and she's like, that guy is hot. And I'm like, really, that guy? She's like, yeah, that guy's fucking hot. And then you find out, you know, Punk was quite the coxman in the locker room. So I'm like, oh, I guess there's something there.
So Rude had just dropped the Intercontinental title at SummerSlam to Warrior because of Piper showing up at the end and just kind of getting involved. So I think that's why there's some... Roddy wrestles in Roddy's Rowdies is one of the teams at Survivor Series.
He's wrestling. It's just Piper almost never wrestled on like say Saturday morning TV or anything. You had to get pay per view to
Hercules. Is always just looks like he's in his ginch.
Yeah, totally. Uncle Steve running around.
Fucking your uncle? Steve, settle down.
I don't know. I don't have an Uncle Steve, but I'm sure
I can see somebody like that.
I was thinking maybe you have an Uncle Steve who runs around in his underwear with his chain. Box, yeah. With a chain. That's Uncle Steve. Oh, here we go.
How was your Thanksgiving, Johnny?
It was good. It was small. They made the right choice and didn't have Mark's parents over. They came over today and they did a little separate thing because it was warm enough to do it outside.
Right.
Yeah. So we kept it to just the household and Mark's the older son and his mom who come over every Sunday anyway. So they're okay. in the bubble.
Nice.
It was nice. We had a great meal.
So how long have you been off work?
No, I worked on the day after Thanksgiving. On purpose, trust me. I can go to a lot of places. There's not a lot of crowds. I'm not getting emails from the office. Tommy Lasorda.
Cool it, Tommy.
I was wondering if this one is.
He's at it again. Just tuning him out.
Jesus.
Fucking classic.
No wonder you got heartburn. Slow down.
Hello. Call 1-900.
this is for one, that 1-900 number. I'm looking for love. All I'm looking for is an older lady. Cigarettes. Oh, I remember these ads.
Interesting.
I've tried everything.
I've only got 3 tumors. A year later, I'm 30 pounds thinner.
You quit smoking or your money back. I stopped eating them.
Absolutely free. Yeah, you'd have that on all the time. Order your cigarette program, call toll-free 1-800. Interesting.
Yeah, I was about to make fun of that man's suspenders until I looked down and I realized, gentlemen, I am wearing a brand new pair of bib overalls I bought for myself today. Nice. And I'm loving them.
Sounds cozy.
They're cozy as fuck with a nice warm tie-dye underneath. It's
until it comes to a public bathroom, you have to take a dump in the public bathroom.
In this era of COVID, I'm trying not to do any.
That's a good idea. Yeah. You hover anyways.
They're not as openly available either.
It doesn't have the back hatch though. It's not those overalls.
So you're saying you look like Hillbilly Jim then?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah,
minus the glorious hair. But with tie-dye underneath, so I look like Hillbilly Dudley.
Oh, nice.
When the Dudleys.
Right.
No phone call. Sorry. If you'd have behaved yourself, you could have had a phone right here. But you don't want to. These guys were
so many balloons.
Right up my ass.
Needed to use this thing to get out this last big.
Is this 1-900-909 old chicks
quiz?
I want to talk to Marty.
So it's Macho King at this point.
Oh yeah, here we go.
I don't know.
Is this with Sherry? Sherry's coming out with him or what?
Yeah. Yep.
Oh yeah.
Yep.
The greatest.
Yep, the best.
I actually walk into the bedroom like that. Play the music.
Yeah. That's what you do tomorrow morning. It's football Sunday. Don't talk to me.
Hey. Paul, my Broncos don't have a quarterback, so we're going to see the first center throw the ball.
I heard, of course, I don't give a shit about football, but I do live in Colorado, so anything Broncos we know about.
Yeah,
you know it's that huge, and I heard about that. No quarterbacks.
Oh,
hey, they could go get Colin
Kaepernick.
They go do the right thing. Get Kaepernick.
It's in 2 days though. They have to go with someone with the playbook.
That's
but
insane.
Kaepernick can run and throw to whoever he can though.
I think Elway should come out of retirement.
Yeah, exactly. Get off my TV trying to sell me your shitty steaks from your steakhouse or your many, many cars.
But he was pumping wine out for Black Friday.
We don't care for you. Those were all like late 20s. It was that whole section, late 20s. Looked like singles too. in a section there. Let's see how this works out.
Well, I don't see. I was going to wrestling shows. There was a single section back at this time.
Wow.
Yeah.
Tried to meet wrestling someone Hercules tonight.
Yeah.
Who's he got?
Hercules.
When did you start going back to wrestling shows, Johnny? What age?
Oh, see, the first live one I went back to was in 90. I don't know. Me and my wife went to Mind Games with Shawn Michaels and Mankind. So that was 97, 96. But I know it might
just
have been
before the Attitude Era was.
Yeah, well, it actually might have been because I happened to see that the WCW was going to do the very last show ever at the Philadelphia Civic Center, and I asked my
smacks
wife,
smacks her in the teeth,
bam, oh. But and I asked her, I was like, would you mind going to see wrestling with me? Because you know, me and my buddy used to go to this place all the time, and this is the last one I'd like to be there. And she, you know, we went and had a great time. So that was probably the
right
return. Opening match as we're walking
in. Oh, yeah, here we go.
It's Benoit Eddie Guerrero. It was pretty awesome.
Wild.
Oh, that's pretty good. Guerrero was awesome.
Yep. And so was he who shall not be named.
Yeah.
Voldemort?
Yep. Basically. Yeah, he's done that twice. No, that ain't why.
Nothing. I was just going to say hello. Oh, she was so great.
Yeah, like them together too. It's just like too much, man.
And this was at the very beginning of the Macho King gimmick because he's not in the
right.
Crazy type.
Yeah,
those
yeah.
Those are just his
original
tights with King instead of Man.
Like I said, I watched SummerSlam, which is like August of this year, and Hacksaw is still the King at that point, and he's still just Macho Man and teaming with Zeus, so something happened in between there.
Yeah. But he doesn't have the yellow knee pads with the stars on them.
Yeah. So I love that he's still in the like this is closer to the classic Macho look before he had all the full gear on by the end.
I always hated the full gear.
Yeah, me too.
Well, he got off a lot of it was getting off steroids, and he had to.
You're not the King.
Then he goes down to WCW for second phase of his career, and he's on all the steroids.
Oh my God, he was as big as Hercules back then.
Yeah.
When he did it.
Yeah,
he had no neck.
Be a man, Hulk.
That era, too. Yeah. That rap album.
Yeah. Oh, I've heard the whole thing. You will drag me out of here in my underwear. I want to be here. He's just.
I'm thinking Hercules, when he's not wrestling, just walks around with his jeans and his shirt up.
Yeah,
I'm sure. Telling you, he's two-toned right now.
Yeah.
A lot of these guys did, man.
Yeah.
I've seen the pictures.
Whitest stems I've ever seen in my life, and then.
Arms off.
Isn't that why Macho Man wore those sunglasses? Just so he wasn't blinded by those legs. I always hated Hercules. I think I even saw him live too. I thought he just.
Yeah, I'm sure he would have been in mid card.
He was strong as hell, yeah, but I don't know.
Yeah, no, never really had.
I didn't like him here, but when he first came to WWF, he was Hercules Hernandez, and I'd also seen him as Hercules Hernandez in the territories, and I just kind of liked him, and I loved the name Hercules Hernandez. What a great name! And then they Vince changed it to Hercules, and then he was the Mighty Hercules, who really thinks he's actually Hercules from. These build from Mount Olympus. And I was like, and he just got, you know, more and more steroids, and
yeah,
he's completely immovable.
Wow. Yeah, he was huge. So wrong.
You can't blame that on me.
Yeah, that's what he's doing. Don't you dare go to HR. Don't you dare. Even Vince was trying to cover up. Could you hear him? He's like, no, she slipped.
Well, the head office isn't going to do anything.
And she was sexy as fuck, man.
Yep.
Who was?
Sherry. Like, she might not look it right now, but I mean, like, dude, there's some of those shows she did it for me. I remember, because she was, like, kind of like the anti-Elizabeth, right?
Right.
I think.
But the whole thing was because they were constantly trying to ugly her up, though. They're trying to, like, make up. Or yeah. She was trying to do all of her makeup. She was always trying to be. I was like, well, you can't. She's a striking woman.
Yeah.
You know, you can't ugly that up.
Yeah.
Did she ever come back, though, like, as the grandma?
Oh, briefly. Oh, what's this? It's for a truck?
Right. Very quickly for Shawn. It was a Kurt Angle.
Shawn Michaels. Yeah, yeah. Shawn Michaels, Kurt Angle, Stetson clone. I had some Stetson back in the day.
Did it help get your truck started in the rain?
It did.
Yeah.
It was a cologne and a lubricant.
And just a drop or two will do.
Uh-huh. Do they still make Stetson?
Oh my god.
Wow, crazy.
This is actually when it first came out.
Yeah.
This was one of those movies when it came out, I was like, I have no interest in seeing this at all. Because European Vacation sucked. And I was like, ugh, what's this?
Paulina Porizkova.
Yeah. Then came out, a buddy of mine was like, you got to see it. And they rented it and watched it. And like, oh my God, it's the funniest one.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, I got to say, it's funny. We love all the vacations. But, you know, the Vegas vacation, there's some classic scenes on it.
Really? I couldn't.
Yeah. Yeah.
I like that one.
I haven't seen it in a long time.
Is the next is page 192? Do you think Vegas Vacation is a good movie at all? Dianetics.
I'm not saying it's a good movie.
I've watched it probably 30 times.
Yeah, we used to watch it all the time when we were younger.
We had it on the movie channel.
Yeah.
The Vegas Vacation one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sid Caesar has a part near the end of that movie, Johnny.
Yeah,
that
they is win.
Fucking awesome, yeah.
My dad took me to see the first one because I wanted to see it, and it was R.
Yeah.
And he laughed his ass off, and then when we're leaving, he starts complaining to me about, you know, I was fucked up, you know, like some little fucked up shit. But then he said, no, I'm like, you can't do that. I heard you laughing throughout the whole goddamn movie. He was trying to do the right thing, you know.
Right. He didn't realize he brought you in a little too early. Kind of thing.
Oh, dude, I was fine with it. I want you to take me to see this movie, and he's like, the cat pissed on the sandwiches and the old woman ate the sandwiches. That's fucked up, Johnny. I talked to my mom about it. You know, be like, oh, I can't believe this terrible, terrible movie he took me to. While he laughed his ass off the entire time.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's a classic.
That kind of
thing. Here we go. Yeah, classic Macho handle. Man. Here we go.
Yeah.
I can't tell you how many times I did that to my sister. At home. She still loves me to this day. But...
Did you have a ring in your backyard?
No, it was just the leather couches in the basement. Okay. Made a good, pretty decent ring.
You gotta admit, McMahon, she can punch for a broad.
He's saying that she'd kick Vince's ass.
Oh, right in the throat.
Don't you guys think he looks Vince, Jackie from Roseanne?
A little, yeah. I see it.
Vince just said she's gonna get hers someday.
Yeah, I see it. What's the name of that actress? Jackie from Roseanne. Jackie from Roseanne.
Oh, Laurie Metcalf?
Yeah, she's got Laurie Metcalf.
She kind of reminds me of her, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. Flying elbow. This is it. No,
it's not down on the ground yet.
Not yet.
We'll get another axe handle.
Double axe. It's three. Learn how to count, you piece of shit.
Who's this ref, Johnny? Do you recognize him?
I do not recognize
him. Me neither.
Oh, The best.
Got Herc kicking out at one there. A nice little push out with authority. Macho making him look like $1 million.
Oh, yeah. Go for the third time.
But no, yeah, see, now we're going to get it.
Or is Herc going to catch him?
No. No. Nope. This will be it.
No, it looks like he's just waiting for a 10.
Yep.
Nope.
No, you're right.
Oh, no.
You called it.
Something happened. There's
you
a called third it. Time.
I think it did make sense that he was kicking out at one. He was going for a little early, I thought.
Ooh, that was like...
Ooh! That was nice. I'm so fucking hype. I love steroids so fucking much. So fucking cool.
Bison's underwear.
Yep.
It's like cocaine, steroids.
I don't even need pants. People love me.
He's a jacked up Alfred Molina from Boogie Nights.
Yeah, Boogie Nights. That's right. Just left the kimono.
He should have a manager who was a little Asian guy.
Yeah, just lighting up firecrackers. That's Cosmo. He's Chinese.
Uh-oh. Aunt Jackie's mad.
Whoa. Ooh, nice. Light as a feather.
I watched that new Roseanne, even though now because they killed off Roseanne, they just called it
the Connors. Connors.
And I like it because I like it. It's got Laurie Metcalf and John Goodman.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'm all in. You know, that's fine.
See, I love it because I'm a big fan of the actor who plays DJ.
Yeah.
I couldn't even finish that sentence without laughing.
He's rarely in it. I do watch the new one. He's actually not bad.
He's got such a weird face. Like he's DJ. Yeah. Like
he had to
grow up in a smoking room.
DJ's in the army, so he kind of comes and goes.
Yeah.
Oh, see, the catch was happening. I knew it.
Oh, yeah.
There it is.
Uh-oh. He better not beat him.
No, not a chance. Not a chance. We'll get some, a little more Cherry involvement, and it'll be a 1-2-3. I swear, I remember. You remember, like it's on tape. I'm in the right here. I want it on the record.
I did not hit you.
We're just wrapping up the office. We've been going through it because we knew it was going to be gone soon. But I think it's like gone like literally in 2 days from Netflix.
Uh-huh.
And Nora loves it. Nora thinks it's the funniest thing. Anything any joke involving a penis, Nora will laugh out loud, even if she doesn't fully understand it. It's so funny.
Well, kind of speaking of that, today I watched, and I haven't finished it yet. I finally was like, what am I going to watch? Well, just hang out. That's it. I finally started watching Dewey Cox, Walk Hard.
Yeah, dude. So good.
That's a good show.
Yeah. You know, when his dad comes to tell him that his mom died, and there's just dicks right in his face.
That's right. Yeah, seeing that on the big screen is quite a bit funnier, as you can imagine. Good God, you're not expecting that.
Oh,
crazy.
What's going on here? He's in the hammock now.
Herc needs a rest. Herc, rest now.
Six.
There it is. Yeah, the purse. There's a solid gold bar in there, Jesse.
Uh oh. Is this it?
I told you, Nazi. That's how it.
It is.
Count to 100.
Macho King reigns again.
At this time, if you're going to get a 3 count on a name guy, it's going to be through cheating if it's a bad guy. That's how WWF was. You'll see that elbow on a jobber on Saturday morning, but maybe on a pay-per-view. Things made out of plastic.
Yeah, it's the Burger King crown.
Mm-hmm. Digs into his scalp, so we had to take it off.
Gotta get you adjust this thing, Jesus. I told you, three clips in the back, third hole.
Well, I love because it's cheaply made, but it's custom because it does say macho on it.
Yeah.
We need 100 of these.
Yeah, he would only get more extravagant and luxurious in his attire from this point on. Especially in the King gimmick.
So that wasn't quite a chair shot. It was a purse shot. We didn't call it.
That's right. Still no chairs.
Yeah.
We're more than halfway through, guys.
I know. I'm getting nervous.
That was an interesting... Yeah. We should have placed bets. It's an interesting thing that Paul threw out there early. I didn't think much of it. What's that box there?
Because Hacksaw, we never had any of this merch ever.
No. Happy. Was your phone call disturbing?
Just the 9-inch rubber wrestlers. What the heck are they? What were they? 9-inch? I had the
Galoobs.
Yeah, or the LJN.
LJN.
Oh, man. Yeah, those are awesome.
Yeah. We had, Brutus.
JYD.
And JYD.
I didn't have. By the time they started coming out with merch, I was too old for it. You know, the freaking little balls, little tiny balls.
Look here. You got it. Now would be a good
time, folks, if you haven't done so already. In fact, oh, you think I'm done, right? You think he can't have any more balloons?
Wait a minute. Is he coming in there and stealing the balloons off their wall? Okay. And here was another reason why when I would tune into wrestling back at this time, I'd turn it off. Because as soon as I'd see this guy, I was like, this is... I understand that you're supposed to boo him, but I was like, I'm booing this because this is unbearable.
Yeah.
Oh, bro. Him, yeah. For a moment there, we're talking about the Red Rooster.
This guy's still employed with WWE? Well, I mean, not still. Like, he's gone and come back a couple of times, I guess, now.
Well, he was
now he's, like high up and, like, creative.
Oh, yeah, he's at the top of the fucking food chain. He was at the top of the food chain for a long, long time.
Yeah.
Even this gimmick, because he was great at this gimmick. He's like, we want you to be a fucking televangelist. And, like, he's great.
Yep.
But I was just, like, it was so annoying. I'm like, why is he a televangelist? It didn't make any sense. I was like,
right.
Why televangelist on this show? He doesn't ask for money. What's
or like on? Trying to convert other like babyface wrestlers or something, like that. Yeah. That's a good point. It was annoying. And it was a start of that I can remember where just segments would really just start to run way too long. Yeah. And which is like something that still happens to this day, obviously.
Oh, is this Andre? Yeah,
but this is, but this colossal was where
connection.
But Brother Love Show was also where all the angles were put forth on Saturday morning television.
What's his story about though? What's because he never wrestled, did he?
Who, Brother Love?
Pritchard?
Yeah. No. Pritchard? No. Well. Brother Love wrestled in like Dusty Rhodes and Sapphire versus Brother Love and you know like that sort of thing is comedy little
stuff. Right, right.
But he was never a wrestler. His brother is one of the best wrestlers of all time.
Wow. Yeah, then Andre can barely go at this point.
Oh, at all. Can't do anything. He's sad.
Crazy. But still, look at that face. There's money in that face, man.
Yeah.
Andre's got that growth on the side of his eye there.
Yeah, I see that.
Eight cubes going.
Apparently, according to
getting close. Can you tell me what this is, doctor? Optometrist.
They used to say that he's got twice as many teeth as a normal man. And talk shit about Andre.
Yes, so many legends.
They look like baby teeth.
They do.
It's just a whole bunch of baby teeth. Thousands of baby teeth.
And they fall out just as every 3 years.
Like a shark, yeah.
Did you guys see the Andre documentary?
Yeah, it was really pretty good. Sad. Yeah.
The HBO one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
My favorite.
Oh, I loved it.
Oh, that was great. My favorite part was her favorite part when Ric Flair had to go, he had a big dick.
Yeah. As I said, anything penis, she loves it. To laugh at.
Oh, look at this. This mythical, how much is this?
Oh, the unicorn, the magic.
The unicorn's powerful
rippling. This is how you guys figure out I'm a replicant.
24 karat gold.
From the mint, the U.S. mint.
Oh, God.
Like that they had all those coins all the time. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
People thought they were going to get rich with these fucking things.
Oh, yeah.
People out there that still have that, like, whole display.
Yeah.
Somebody still does. Any day now.
A bunch of plates.
It's your retirement fund.
I think I'm lousy with these fucking birthdays. I don't
know what filling that out all caps. Unicorn on the
money order.
Yes.
On the money order, yes. That you have to get it to.
There you
the
go. $9.95 to unicorn.
There's one thing you gotta pay. Really focused on.
This child is in danger. Aliens have taken your kids, buddies. I remember this ad.
I do remember this ad as well. This is the Time Life books, right? Yeah. Oh my God.
Yeah, I love this shit.
It freaked me out so much.
These are great. These are fun. It's all horse shit, but it's
I know. I want to find these. I bet you could find them at like a thrift store or something.
Yeah, I've read these. They're a blast. It's the Hardy Boys.
What's wrong with Clyde?
This is how the X-Files was created.
Basically, yeah, it's a lot of that same sort of
In
shit.
Search of, the show In Search of, when I was a kid, hosted by Leonard Nimoy, like, first introduced me to all that shit, and I just...
Oh, I remember there's a couple different versions of that ad. I remember there's one where a guy's like, a man is about to board a plane, but for some reason decides not to. Minutes later, the plane goes down in flames. Like, it was like all these weird things.
Mm-hmm.
I remember that In Search Of show too. That used to scare the shit out of me every time I saw
it. Yeah, it was spooky. If that, it was on Saturday afternoons, which made it feel not as spooky. But if that had been on at night and I watched it, I probably would have been too.
Yep.
Yeah.
I could get through it at 5 o'clock in the afternoon.
Hey, what is the first pay-per-view ever? A boxing match, I'm assuming.
Oh, first pay-per-view ever, like in general. I don't know. First sporting pay-per-view?
That's a good question.
Because I'm sure there was movies.
But probably the first live event, or were they live? They're probably taped.
I don't know. There he is, Tiny Lister.
Is that Forrest Whitaker?
Yeah,
they got the same thing.
It's
first pay per view. Got an answer for you on it.
September 16th,
1981. That's it.
Yeah.
That was Sugar Ray and Thomas Hearns.
Yeah. Nashville, Tennessee.
I don't think Wyndham made the show, right? Because Wyndham's on this, but I think he quit.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So
he was the Widowmaker.
I don't remember who?
Is that Dino Bravo?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh my God, look at him.
Yeah.
Straight out of the Party Quebecois.
Yeah.
Look at him, he's pumping up there, ready for a smoke down St. Catherine.
Dart?
Yeah, he's going to smoke a dart and drink some Molson Export. Who is that guy in the vest there? The outlaw?
Barry Windham.
Barry
Windham was known as the Widowmaker. But he's
that's
awesome.
Right. That's right. Yeah, I remember him. Yeah, that's right.
He's more known for that same sort of like NWA and Crockett stuff that Johnny was talking about before.
Yeah. Oh boy, look at this. They're an army. This is awful.
Dino look like Rick Moranis? Like a roided up Moranis. Oh, here we go.
Valentine.
Valentine, he did say Valentine.
There's no brain power in that room.
Yeah.
Garvin was a pilot. I mean, so he's got
a lot of eyeballs looking in different directions. Yeah.
That's Achifora. Achifora disease. One's looking at you, one's looking for you.
Yeah. Him and Zeus must be related.
bet.
It's gonna hell of a match.
Put them together, you'll actually have some good eyesight.
They're just missing their lockups by like 8 inches each side.
This is just the start of Brett's singles run. And here you see, but Anvil's just like a plug at this point. They never had anything for him. Honky Tonk's still around.
Look at me, I stole his hat.
Oh, there's the rocker. Hat,
baby.
It's like, wait a second. That's not supposed to be on that guy. It's supposed to be on the police officer. Not this time.
Just stole his hat, baby.
Oh, there's the Red Rooster boys on the Dream Team.
Sorry. Sorry, Tito. We only have a size medium.
Boy, that's the shittiest team out of the whole Survivor Series.
Well, if you look at
which one?
This one?
Not this one.
If you look at actual
Terry
talent,
Taylor. Yeah.
We were still looking at the other screen.
Yeah. We had the other one. Where are you guys at on your?
We are.
I'm looking at Dusty Rhodes and Beefcake.
116.05.
Okay.
I'm like, three of those guys are actually great wrestlers.
Yeah.
Beefcake stinks.
I'm
a male stripper who wants to cut your hair with garden shears.
Cut your fucking face off.
With leotards on his forearms.
Yeah. I think my mom used those shears to cut my hair when I was a kid back in the
day. Did she have those tights on too?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Oh, look at Snuka. That's the look at Snuka's face. That's the look Snuka makes after he murders a woman.
No kidding. I was thinking we'd see him, but I was hoping we'd get to see the Rougeaus in action, because I really like this era of them. This is when they're coming into all American boys, like rubbing it in the Americans' faces. They're from Quebec. That's so funny.
But they were waving little American flags.
I know, pretending that they're like, we love America. It's hilarious.
I was actually just reading an article. Their nephew plays one of the guys that's on the Rougeaus. His nephew's on the New York Rangers.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I forget what his last name. I mean, it's obviously.
It's obviously Rougeau. Or is Rougeau not their last name?
It's not Rougeau. No, it's different.
Oh, sweet, sweet. Colombian gold. Expensive ski trip. Some will make their homes more comfortable
all year long. So 1989 insulation.
The fish is dead.
Yep. Man.
And 2020, 30% of America has cancer because of this insulation.
Yeah, no shit.
Hot. It's great. Oh, hold on. Hot romance connection.
Fish is alive.
Hi.
Man, there's a lot of these at this time.
1-900-909.
It is the same number. That's you should not hour. Be doing a teen one. With one day off.
Yeah, yeah. Hi, I'm looking for some teen fun. Hello, honey.
Where's Edna? I want to speak with Edna.
Yeah. Excuse me, how old are you?
Hey,
hey, man. My beer farts are toxic. This is the look what it says. This is the life insurance I talked about on TV. And so when you get it in the mail, and you're the old person goes, "Oh, honey, it's the life insurance that McMahon talked about on TV."
Is he going to start talking to us now? Is this little piece of cardboard going to?
Do I have to lick this first?
Hello, Edward.
Hi-yo.
It's a painting.
This
is my neighborhood.
No salesman will. Hey.
You know, Ed McMahon was pretty famous for being Johnny's sidekick. Like, where the hell did this come from?
He was also doing that at this time, and Star Search. He was also known for.
He was hosting.
Oh, Ed McMahon was the jokes for the Jeffrey Tambor character on the Larry Sanders Show. I'd taken any gig was totally based on Ed McMahon.
Yeah.
Hank Kingsley. Hey-o.
De-scrambler. You don't hear that word very often these days, you guys. De-scrambler. I'm gonna hook up to the scrambler. Don't worry, we're gonna have hockey here in a minute, you guys. Sit tight.
We're gonna hear that on Legends of Tomorrow eventually. Yeah. Send out the scrambler
for sure.
The dish.
was just so that's so the boobs, you can see the boobs in the Super Channel. If you
yeah,
Matt is just fine with it being scrambled.
Like, you gotta get this stuff at the end here, you blow it up a bit.
This is this. I'm tripping balls.
I think I'm done for the night. Just kidding.
Doing nitrous.
Yeah. So this is right when they're just about to, because the next WrestleMania is Hogan Warrior, right? Where it's kind of the passing of the
torch. Rowdy, squeak out the fart with his balloon.
I did hear that. I couldn't tell if that was you guys doing that. That's why I kind of laughed.
Holy shit, Mel Phillips is still around at this
wow.
point. That fucking sex creep.
That announcer, you guys, is known for sneaking in and sucking on guys' toes.
And also being hotel inappropriate with children.
Really? I didn't know that part.
Yeah, that's disturbing.
Now it's not so, whimsical, Johnny.
Well, here we go.
The toe-sucking it's still fine.
And no, I mean, in a culture of a blew ya gimmick, mate, then it's like par for the course.
I guess so.
Yeah. I didn't know that.
Jesus, about is that's Warrior good. Losing his shit. Man, yeah. No wonder that guy's heart exploded.
He was a groomer.
Yeah.
I didn't buy into him as like a 6 to 8 year old. Others
I hated him.
I hated him too.
Again, every now and then I go, what's on wrestling, and see this guy. Because I'd first seen when he was the Dingo Warrior in World Class and stuff.
Yeah.
And then he came up here. And every now and then I go, well, what's going on wrestling? And then see this fucking clown running around. Like, he sucks. Mm-hmm. I hate his gimmick.
His tassels. Yeah, his shit sucked. I wasn't a big fan.
I hated him.
However, yes, I agree with you. But that... SummerSlam, the Rude match, the match he has with Rude is awesome. And it's not just on Rude. It's not just Rude that carries him. Yeah. And the
two good matches, right?
The Savage match. The Savage match is so good. It's one of the best WWF matches ever. And the Hogan match is good. The Mania match I'd mentioned before. So he has three good matches.
Yeah, well, those are three of the best of all time, this fucking clown.
I know. Yeah.
I mean, Tully right here is one of the best of all time. I don't know how much he's going to get out of fucking right here.
So Arn's gone, right?
No, they're both still there.
Oh, they're still there?
Yeah.
Ha! That's awesome. This Tully just looks like somebody's dad, like a softball coach. Tully, that's what I always thought. And Arn Anderson looks like a shop teacher.
I know.
That's what makes them so awesome, man.
This is a deep dive thing, but someone on Twitter who I like and get along with said that I saw today that the Tully Blanchard Magnum TA I Quit match was great, but it doesn't hold a candle to the John Moxley Kenny Omega one. And I was about to be like, I have to unfriend this guy.
Yeah. Oh, man. If there's like a Tully Blanchard Magnum TA. I think
it's the greatest match of all time.
One of the best matches ever. It's insane. It's like I don't want to give away much, but it involves like a table leg.
A shard of wood, a broken chair.
Yeah, crazy.
Just two guys doing no wrestling moves for the entire time, just beating the shit out of each other, trying to get each other to say, I quit.
Ugh, God.
You know, a microphone, which could be awful, but they make it feel like, these guys are really fighting, I think.
Yeah,
you know,
it's intense. Wild.
This has to be the shittiest matchup the Warrior ever had. Like, he should have just ran into the ring, fucking clotheslined the guy, pinned him, and ran right back out the opposite side of the arena.
But that's where the money was with him, right? That's how he beat Honky Tonk after the greatest intercontinental reign of all time. But
eventually in wrestling, you can't do that. You got to
right. So you got to do a bit, right? Yeah.
Because he would blow up by that running to the ringside.
Yeah.
You know, by the time he got to the ring, he was blown up already.
He's the opposite of Boss Man in terms of conditioning, like we were talking about earlier.
He's got the body, but Boss Man has a fucking tank, you know, and can
that's right. He could go long. Yeah. Fuck, he might trip on those tassels.
Tassels. I didn't like Sting either at the time as a solo guy in WCW. I thought he was silly. But I liked Sting better than this guy because at least I knew that I knew that Sting was a great wrestler. I was like, this guy's really good. I just never really cared for the gimmick. Oof. And I was first introduced to them when they were a tag team called the Blade Runners and Bill Watts UWF. Blade Runner Sting and Blade Runner Rock.
But I mean, he got over. Like, we can't deny. Yeah, like, he briefly got over.
He got over. They put the belt on him. It was back on Hogan in a year because it sucked and it didn't work. And he was a piece of shit in real life. So fuck this guy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I changed my name to Warrior legally. That's lovely. That's
insane.
I get it.
Firing others, yeah.
I get if that's your fuck you to Vince, fine. That's given. Then his wife has to say, my name is Dana Warrior. what are you doing? Your poor children. I remember watching him on that Raw after WrestleMania and thinking to myself, this motherfucker looks like he's about to have a fucking heart attack.
I know. And sure enough, that's what happened. That last speech, though, man, is so... It's creepy how, if you know, that's like literally the last thing he said. It's so wild.
I'm going to go outside and literally stop my own heart right now.
Yes.
Before I say something really stupid again about homosexuals.
Yeah, he was a nutter. Hey, Paul, are you still there?
Yes.
All right, just making sure.
He's putting his face makeup on.
Look, shaking, he don't pick on me. He's going to stomp out of the room like one of the bushwhackers.
Yeah, I thought either that or he's just running around shaking the curtains. Dun, 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 dun.
We have to go. How long with
Tully? Save that there. That wasn't bad.
He didn't do anything.
Yeah, I know.
He literally didn't do anything. Well, Tully did a giant forward roll. Here comes Arn. Arn might have been injured. I don't know.
Ah, there he is.
Oh, here we go.
Kaboom! Galooly!
Yeah.
You can hit him with a pipe. Galooly! Wouldn't mind seeing a sidewalk slam. Hmm?
Who is this guy?
Arn Anderson.
Arn Anderson. These guys were the Brain Busters. So they were part of the Four Horsemen with Ric Flair and everybody.
Look how many giant hands got sold throughout the night. There's way more in the crowd now. This must be the end of the night.
Oh, we need Andre to come down.
Oh, if this ends with them just all beating the shit out of the Warrior, then I'm happy.
Then this could be all right. Yeah, right, because it's got to get those kids excited for this when you see it.
Yeah.
Ah, there's the Young Rockers. And where's Andre? Andre's going to walk down slowly,
if at all.
No. I'm going to skip this one, boss.
This almost looks like the fights that are happening at the local mall.
Oh, yeah, here he comes.
Black Friday.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go.
So maybe you can find a way to clean house here. All four of them. That would be good.
Andre's eye thing is leaking right now.
I can't go in there. It hurts. It stings, boss.
A Warrior. We're seeing it all, guys. There you go.
His little warrior.
It's like, you wish. I didn't know.
And they all,
I'm going to change my name to Warrior from Warstein. That's what we could tell from that last shot. There you go. I knew that would take a while.
Oh, it registered. No, Warstein
was a little clumsy.
I know.
Is that an indication of what it's going to be like at the Rosemont?
Well, maybe. I don't know. Why are you asking me? This whole thing is crazy.
This is the first Survivor Series where they went down from the 5 to 4. 5 teams, five wrestler teams to 4. It's like, oh man.
I got
it. What a night.
Look at.
I wasn't sure if I was going to do this.
What's funny is you see there's yellow balloons up behind Brain and Heenan. They're all in the same studio. It's
just he's just been pulling them out one by one and then blowing them out afterwards.
What I can get away with. Vince, I'm the golden child now.
He's rubbing it in their faces. No. Why don't you ever enter a
contest? Why you just sit there and you talk about how great you are? I never liked good guy Roddy Piper.
For a short time. I mean, it worked for the retirement with Adonis.
With Adonis, well, because that was like, here's his. Oh, here we go. Demolition always disturbed.
Oh yeah.
They did not look cool. They looked fucking terrible. Look at this old man. Look at that. Look at this old man.
The Tin Man about to die of the same disease the Tin Man died of from that.
He's going to get sick like Buddy Ebsen. He's got enough oil in his hair that Buddy Ebsen shot it.
Oil
in Tennessee.
Yeah. He's covering both ends.
Yeah, Demolition as Babyface never really made sense either.
Yeah. People thought they were cool. I know people who love Demolition because they grew up with them. I was also, when I first saw them, I was like, oh, they're ripoffs of the Road Warriors, which is what they were. I don't care how much.
Yeah,
I know that Bill Eadie here was a better technical wrestler than they, but they were Road Warrior ripoffs. That's what they were.
There were other Road Warrior ripoffs too.
There was tons of them. Powers of Pain. There was look at Jake. I wear Stetson.
He was awesome though.
It's like Hogan doesn't even know he's there.
Yeah.
And if Jake was here, I'm sure he'd agree with me.
I love that he's just like, bring the energy down.
The man on the most cocaine and talks the slowest in the promos.
Man, we watched a card about a month ago with Max Paul, our buddy. That's like 10 years from now when Jake is so whacked out on crack cocaine and it is not pretty. It was a mess. Yeah. It was a mess.
He was a big star. Back around this time, he was pretty big.
Oh,
like
yeah.
His battles with like Macho Man and
Steam. Oh my God. That's still shocking to this day that they allowed a cobra to bite into. Like I saw that on TV. That was insane.
Apparently at the time, they were trying to like, maybe we should push the envelope a little. Oh, what is this?
That looks delicious, you guys.
The food locker. Vacuum sealer.
That looked like
that nervous poop I heard about earlier. Veggies. Who has a bag that says veggies? Fuck you. I've seen that cookbook. Holy shit.
Oh my God. That is so gross.
The dinner of the future, you guys.
Look, shrimp this woman is crazy. Look at this. Nobody does that. All the pieces of your husband's body.
I can't believe this didn't take off.
She looked so thrilled to be.
Yeah.
Food locker.
Honey, get in here. It was the secretary. Honey, get in here. Point at the food locker. Allowed 2 to 4 weeks. 2 to 4 weeks for your fucking food locker.
Oh no! All my vegetables are gonna go bad.
Hold on. Yo-yos. We got yo-yos, baby. Oh, this guy. That guy's a panty grabber.
Yo-yos and condoms.
This one gets them wetter than the fucking ocean, baby. Get imperial.
What's this trick? The old midnight special.
I'm flambo.
What's that guy up to these days, I wonder?
The bench brute. Open even with a lid
closed. Removable dividers, organized drawers, and drawers. Stir your yo-yo in this shit or what?
Yep. Hey, you got room for? He's gonna show up at the end. You got room for this?
Walking from set to set.
Yep.
that guy.
Yeah, that was awesome too.
Oh, the construction worker made that. Find out the Thanksgiving night tradition that's been around for a year and a half.
So many balloons. They were not there at the beginning, you guys.
He just kept bringing them in there.
Yeah.
He's rubbing this in our face. But there still leaves a lot to be desired in the Hina family right now. You know that, and I know that. I'm not going to
answer your phone call. Whatever went down is that has nothing to do with your business. White hat's pretty bad. I can find one of those somewhere.
You'd wear that right now.
In the summertime on the beach? Ooh, that'd be pretty bad.
You're already married.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
I wear DiBiase's dinner jacket there. That would look good.
Yes.
Oh, actually, that shirt is even better. Sun's out, guns out.
There it is.
Where the hell was Virgil on this? How come he's
there?
Out?
Isn't he?
Is he there?
I thought I saw him. It's going to be a solo demolition.
I remember as a kid seeing that mask scared the shit out of me. Like,
oh yeah, yeah, the entrance of that gear. Oh yeah. Yeah. I don't know, it's totally Mad Max, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, totally.
It all was for Mad. I mean, it was all Mad Max. You know?
Beyond the Thunderdome.
Yeah.
The Mad Max movies had more influence on professional wrestling than any other. Anything else. There wasn't a spate of apocalyptic movies. Maybe there were some, but wrestling just everywhere, just filled with them after that movie.
Oh,
there's my bald spot. I look threatening as fuck. Made up.
And
like
so you know who Smash would go on to become? Nazi?
No.
Repo Man.
Oh, is that? Oh, you know what? I think I knew that one. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I think I was just so distracted by his face makeup. Like, yeah. He almost looked like Giuliani's freaking hair dye there.
That's his next move.
That's his next gig, yeah.
Okay, Smash just put DiBiase's money down his tights. Yeah. That's not the first time that gimp outfit has had $100 bills go down those tights. That was another DiBiase thing. Was awesome. When I first saw Demolition, I was like, these guys look like leather dudes. I mean, I know I'm old enough to know what a leather dude is, and that's what they look like.
Bring out the gimp.
Mm-hmm. Yep. The sparkly studs on their fucking tights. We need a little flare.
Yeah, yeah. That was...
This is what Travis always wanted to dress up as when we were wrestling as kids.
Yep.
Really? That explains a lot.
Demolition. Oh, my God.
More sequins. More sequins.
You just went in your mom and dad's closet.
I was just going to say, we'll just go get mom and dad's play clothes.
Yeah. Or you could just take mom's purse and just put the straps around your body.
Exactly. Just strap it in. Way too tight.
God. DiBiase looked like Kenny Rogers wrestling.
Yeah, at this point, he had that Kenny Rogers hair.
Yeah, totally.
But he's awesome. Right. Like
he's one of the greatest.
Yeah. He was good. Yeah, he was good. His gimmick was awesome.
Yeah, and before this, like his wrestling, like he had legendary feuds, and like the iron. What was the glove he always wore?
Oh, he had his black loaded glove down in Mid South. I mean, yeah, he had a long and storied, amazing career. But he had just had this. He'd been a heel forever, and he had this big baby face run, where he started wearing his hair like this and started frosting his hair. Because he always had black hair as a baby, as a heel. And he suddenly had this bouffant of exactly Kenny Rogers.
Yeah.
Frosted hair that he brought up here, and they turned him into a heel with it.
Mm.
He was a good heel at this time, though.
Oh, the best.
Throwing money on people and stuff. Yeah, it was good.
At the time when he came up, I hated it because I thought it was cartoony. Because I was watching this guy have these like blood feuds in the South. Blood feuds about honor and bullshit and titles, and now he's like, "I'm a millionaire," and I'm like, "Okay, But looking back on it, I'm like, oh, it's one of the best of all time.
It was good, yeah.
It was so good.
Well, what was his line there? Everyone's got a price for the $1 mask.
Or when he kicked the basketball out of the, when the kid had to bounce it 20 times in a row, and at 19 he kicks it away. That's so...
When he goes to the jeweler to get his $1 million bow.
Yeah. And he goes, didn't he shove the money down their throats too?
Yeah. After
I thought that was his thing all the time. He'd push it in. Yeah, it was pretty good.
I just wanted a reason why he became a millionaire for me. I was just like, Ted DiBiase, noted wrestler, came into a ton of money recently or something. I just wanted that.
He won the Powerball.
Yeah, or something.
Just invested well. Things have gone well for me. Mm-hmm. I've been lucky. I've been fortunate. That's the gimmick. That's the gimmick. I had a couple good tips. 20 years of history.
20 years in the business, and he's suddenly, he invested his money correctly.
Just turned the corner. Just turned the corner.
Age 136 of Dianetics.
No, I remember being so...
Yes, that's the answer. It all comes together. It's deep down, it's in the S stands for Scientology. Not a dollar sign.
That's so funny. That's so funny.
God, I haven't thought of Repo Man in ages. Now that's all I think of when you show.
But that's like, there you go. And all those blue collar jobs are just around the corner, right?
Look at those. Yeah. That outfit is terrible on that man. Yep.
His wife didn't think so.
Mrs. Repo. He had been right before he came here. Barry Darsall Smash. He was Crusher Khrushchev down in Crockett. Who had a unique gimmick. He was with the Russians, but he was supposed to be, you know, an American who turned his back.
Oh, really?
He turned his back on America and changed his name to Crusher Khrushchev. And hung out with Ivan and Nikita Koloff, the quote-unquote real Russians. And he had to, because they'd give their promos and be like, oh, you first, Ivan? He's like, We will get Dusty Rhodes in cage, and we will end this career. You, nephew Nikita, you say what you do. Oh, girl, Ivan, when I get on my hands on a magnum tear, I break him. Oh, what do you have to say about a Crusher? Road warriors. Warriors of the road. We will defeat you. He just sounded like the whitest American white guy.
Hilarious.
Oh, Women's Secret Confessions. That's a different fucking number. Brrr.
It's just so many different numbers.
909, 11.
What are they confessing?
It's for
you. Hold on. That was, you call women pretending to be in distress and you make them feel better. Oh. And they pretend to make you feel. That's bunk. Hey, Superman's 50. Who cares? Fuck you.
I drew that.
I care. You'll get this guy's shitting on this. Call now and you'll also get Time magazine.
And where are they now? Yeah. It's the magazine of yesterday. US News. That's the future. And we're going to throw in this sweet sound system.
Here we go.
I think it's actually 4 inches long.
The receiver's the size of a cassette.
Yep.
what year is that song from, though?
We didn't say how big the stereo was, did we? No.
It sounds awful.
Hey, where's the best place in America? Is it 1-900-989-8080?
Yeah.
Hi.
I wonder if you phone this number right now, what would happen?
And Drescher?
The guy in the middle there was like, how did I get both of you on the car? <It's like>
we'll show you how to use a phone. Hi. Why wait? Your ass is mine.
Alf. Phone's for you.
And now I'm fucking smashed.
Oh, he's coked out of his gourd at that point. I don't know if you've ever. There's a great. It's a fun movie called about Doug Kenny, one of the founders of National Lampoon, and you know, went on, did Animal House and everything. It's a, I think it's a Netflix movie about his life. It's pretty funny. But there is a scene where it's him and Chevy Chase just doing all the cocaine. And Chevy Chase is played by the dude who was on Community, the star Community.
Donald Glover?
No.
No, I know who you're talking about. Like
anyway, but it's just it was cocaine. It was WWF 89 cocaine fueled. Goddamn, lost. Trying to remember that motherfucker's name. Buddy.
It's a long walk.
It's a long.
We're hitting near the end here.
I know we're getting to this.
Speaking
next.
Of which, dude, I was listening to my birthday one for a while back, and you're noticeably sloshed by the end.
Oh, I was. Well, no, because we did
watching it again. I was like, holy fuck, Johnny's.
No, no, it's. Oh well, it's because we did a double header of Gideon right. Guys, and early in the day.
That's
and
right.
And me instead of like. I just like, remember that. It's Saturday.
I have to remember that. Yeah, it's the first time I've really noticed that. Out of all these, this is our 16th episode, 16th or 17th of these we've done since COVID started.
Yeah. It wasn't super embarrassing. I just kept telling the same stories over and over again.
It's still awesome. At that point, it fits right in with everything.
Yeah, boy, this is.
Mm-hmm. This is our main event, guys. This is we're going okay. out here with extended headlocks, wrestling. I love you, brother. No, you're the best.
Smash, even a dumb name.
Mm-hmm. I mean, but this has to end with, like, if they've got, well, this might not even be, they might give us something with Hogan and them one more
they
time.
They might have, you know, they want to, they're going to.
But this can't just be like, see it Survivor Series.
Yeah, exactly. It's not going to be just see it Survivor Series here. You know, something's going to happen.
Yeah.
I'm thinking DiBiase is winning it for sure. Something cheap is going to happen.
Why are they giving him so much time here? Yeah.
The $1 million belt.
I can't sure
they can make replicas of those by now, eh? Like everybody, you can get everything these days. I'm sure there's somebody who owns $1 million belt. So there's several people.
I can't remember how many times I ever actually saw DiBiase beat anybody in WWF.
It's a good point. Other than Andre surrendering the title. Oh, that's what I wanted to say. Before I lost my train of thought, is I was hating him at that point when. Andre surrendered the title after the mix up with the twin refs that we were talking about earlier. Yeah.
The Hebner.
Yeah. That guy, I was furious. And that was awesome heel work at that point.
What's fun is if you can look it up, like DiBiase actually wore the belt at a couple of house shows and was billed as the champion for a week. Tag matches of him and Andre versus Hogan and somebody. Bam Bam Bigelow, as a matter of fact.
Huh. I wish I would have stretched that out. It's too bad. Didn't last as long.
See, this is a wrestling.
That's not Rhino. That looks like Rhino Smash.
It's got a little more length. It's a little taller. Rhino's just
a lot taller. A lot.
Okay. Rhino's Ram Man.
Rhino goes up to that guy's tits.
Who we got walking down here is just another.
He's Danny DeVito height.
Here we go, Zeus.
He's walking.
Tiny.
I think he was trying to walk into the stands, but his eye took him to the ring.
First of all, Corbin Dallas, thank you for your bravery.
Yeah, this is a big move.
So he couldn't do anything, right? He can't wrestle. He's not a wrestler. He's an actor. So that, like, they'll just give him these like leap, like he's just bear hugs and like neck snaps, and the neck snaps look nasty. That's fine.
He was a big foe of Hogan for a while there.
Yeah,
well, and it's sold. In as the big guy.
Yeah, well, yeah. But like for every like, apparently it sold well, Johnny. Like better than some of like other like it did better at the gate than some of like the other feuds he had at the time.
Yeah,
for a guy who's not a wrestler, and for yeah. a movie who's that wasn't popular.
Yeah.
Well, 89, they were still on fire. They could still this was a wrestling challenge taping. Now, they were getting, normally at these wrestling challenge tapings, it'd be 4 or 5 hours of nothing but jobber matches,
right.
with one match with Hogan at the end to keep everyone. And this wrestling challenge crowd actually got some good matches. Mm-hmm. But these people were willing to sit for 5 hours and watch jobber matches.
Yeah.
At this point, so they could be on TV, maybe, or get fuck to see Hulk Hogan. Bullshit, man.
There's Virgil. Selling autographs.
Exactly. Like Tiny Lister's looking at Virgil with just such disdain.
Some self-respect, man.
That outfit.
Got the Terry Crews packs going.
Totally. Yeah. Like he had a look, right?
Especially, yeah, he like, was even
with that, even with the wonky eye, like that added to like he's off, yeah. man. Something's off. Something's off with this dude. He'll fuck you up.
Well, and you compare it to the wrestlers now, like these guys are so big and jacked up. Like mm-hmm. they almost look like superhuman, and then now they're all skinny. Right? Like,
mm-hmm.
How long you was big guys. WWF, how long was he there for? 6 months?
Zeus? 3 months, even, if that. Yeah.
If that.
Like, I think he stretched. They got 2 pay-per-views out of him. So it's, yeah, like he was on SummerSlam and he was in the Survivor Series, but I think that was basically it. I think there was a
they had the one pay-per-view where they had the cage match with Hogan and Beefcake versus him and Savage, but it was, you got that match and you got to watch No Holds Barred on pay-per-view.
That's right.
Yeah.
I can only remember the one scene, Stan Hansen scene. From
he's got a little teeny weeny
teeny wangers. That's what he says.
Teeny wanger.
He walks in on like these two suits walk into this fight club and bathroom, and they're
oh, and they're not just two suits. They're not just two suits. They are the most anti-Semitic characters you've ever seen.
Yes.
In a movie. Network executives. Stan Hansen looks at their tiny Jewish Hollywood penises and says, "Looks like we got some tiny wangers in here." Yeah,
that's all I can remember from No Holds Barred.
No, I remember there's a scene, and you got to look for this. There's a scene where Hogan's riding his motorcycle, and in the background, they didn't notice it. A man is throwing a dog into a lake.
Into the lake. That's where I have seen yep. that. I forgot about that. There's a gif of that.
Yep, and you have to look it up for the Hulk Hogan love scene, which is funniest.
Disturbing.
I remember our grandpa had Super Channel, the movie channel.
Yeah.
And he recorded it.
Recorded No Holds Barred for
us.
Awesome. Thanks, Grandpa. Well, we're getting near the end here, guys. I wonder how we're going to wrap this thing up. They can't just be going back to Roddy and his balloon.
5 minutes, maybe.
This was a mistake. I think there's one more in there. He's like sweaty and he's like pale, like pasty white. Something went wrong, you guys.
Something went really, really wrong.
They're gonna carve me open. The wrestlers. Like, this wasn't just for me, by the way. I'm doing this for
the wrestlers. Are gonna carve him open. Splay him out on the table in their hotel room and snort his intestines.
So we're good. Are we just gonna?
Here we go. Commercial? What's this?
Okay. I remember that show.
This me at the strip club. Are you looking for love or I am. Call the new romance
hotline. So many phone numbers.
This was the original one. This is for the old people. 8,000. Got it.
There's the old lady. That's what got us all. Fired up here tonight, you guys.
I want Tim Meadows making out with an old white woman. 909 8,000. $2 for the first minute. 40.
45 cents in a whole minute.
They don't show their faces.
We have to hide.
Hey, a young John Mahoney, a young Fraser Crane's dad. This had to be pre. No, this is probably just before Say Anything hits.
Yeah, this is when he's just like that. I did a working actor in everything.
I did a commercial within the last 2 years for a company called Hear USA. I've never seen. It's probably the same type of thing.
Same cardigan.
Yes, I have a nice
same
cardigan.
Hair
again. I wear it all the time.
My tooth. You just put it in here.
How about that? Is that crazy? Just like here, I can hear aliens now. It's crazy.
All those terrible voices are now gone. Page 176. The Miracle Ear Center is part of Scientology.
Is that what we're gonna get? Is that how this thing is gonna end with one more ad for fucking?
It's going to. I bet you it is. Hot.
It's so close. The seniors.
It's crazy wild. See the squiggles?
It's like it's just off by one number. I didn't know I was committing a crime, officer.
Wait a sec.
She sounded just like Mildred.
Troy Aikman. Consideration paid for by the following. We get a little Lord Alfred there.
The old man is like, battleship my ass. I was on the Indianapolis. Fuck yourself.
Ditka? You got a little bit of everybody, a little bit of 89.
Fuck him too.
What? No, I don't care. Really don't care.
Well, it was one of the things he came out with. Oh, Stetson. Hold on. You know that's good. Lord Al
doing the
great masculine scent of Stetson.
Oh, wow. And him doing, yeah. So, yeah, we had that exact one, you think, Paul?
Oh, yeah. Pointless.
Yeah, it was shitty.
Pointless.
Remotes back then. The remotes and NES just didn't work.
Pointless.
I know, I don't like that.
A waste of money.
Is that what you said to your parents? You stormed in yes. like a bushwhacker. These controllers, this game, pointless.
Travis Merry is wearing his action smash outfit.
By the way, I'm keeping these.
This man is out of his mind on cocaine.
This one I'm gonna keep.
I'm a survivor, baby. Well, put the pin to it. You're done too, pal. Okay.
It's gonna be interesting. It's the one labeled for him because that's for all the cooks in, and they're gonna just pop it. It's gonna...
just like LeBron James at the start of a game. Has always been excitement
personified. This year guaranteed will be no exception. A fun Saturday night in Winnipeg for Roddy.
Yeah. Well, I guess we'll see you guys at Survivor Series and next week in 1989. I got a feeling deep down inside, folks, that we're in
for a big surprise. Hot Rod, I know your team is ready. Ain't done yet. One more. The Heenan family.
Ridiculous. He did what he could. You got balloons, Roddy. You got balloons. Just do something with balloons, okay? We got 2 hours to fill. All right. Yeah, I'll see what I can do.
Put my name on this one, though.
It's a last minute request. I got it. Awesome, guys. I think that's it.
He took a class at the UCB because he's out in Hollywood now.
Yes, prepare for improv. This.
Uh-huh.
Fantastic. Another one in the books. See ya.
Thank you.
Good night.